Mark 11:12-14, Mark 11:21-24, faith only gives fruits when it is signed in God. 12 And the next day, when they came out of Bethany, he was hungry. 13 And when he saw afar off a fig tree that had leaves, he went to see if there were any in it. And he came to her, and found nothing but leaves, for it was not the time of figs. 14 And Jesus said to the fig tree, Let no one eat fruit from you any more. And his disciples heard it. Mark 11:12-14. And Peter remembered and said unto him, Master, behold, the fig tree which thou cursed is dried up. And Jesus answering said unto them, Have faith in God. For verily I say unto you, Whosoever shall say unto this mountain, Arise, and cast thyself into the sea, and doubt not in his heart, but believing that it shall be done that which he saith, whatsoever he saith shall be done unto him. Wherefore I say unto you, All things whatsoever ye shall ask, pray, believing receive, and ye shall have them. Mark 11:21-24. Dear brothers in Christ, it is with great joy that we are studying the Word of God together with you, in the presence of the Creator of heaven and earth, in the presence of the Lord Jesus Christ, and in the presence of the Holy Spirit. All things are created for an end, and every end is useful or useless. And all things also have two forms, a productive, beneficial format, the other side an unproductive, useless format. In our trajectory, we learn from our parents that we should be useful. We must be productive. That we should not only be consumeristic, that is, survive what others do. When God spoke to Abraham to go out from the midst of his kinsmen, and to an unknown land, God gave an errand to Abraham, be your bench. The divine guidelines also coincide with the guidelines of our parents. The desire of our parents is that the children be a blessing. But like all things, there are two forms and two sides. There are people who follow the advice of the parents and also follow the advice of God, and they are also a blessing. But there are people who do not listen to their parents and do not listen to God, but listen to the world and hear the spirit of the world, which is the spirit of the evil one, and they are not a blessing, but they are a curse. They are cruel, they are thieves, murderers, so they are a curse. And what we want to understand, through the Holy Spirit today, is that we were created to be a blessing, to bear good fruit, and to bring this awareness of good to others, and to bear good fruit. In today's study, in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 11, verses 12 to 14, Jesus Christ was traveling from Bethany to other cities, and feeling hungry looking for something to eat. And seeing a fig tree, he noticed that it was leafy, with many leaves, but as he approached, he saw that there were no fruit. Noting that the fig tree was of no use, he determined that the fig tree would wither, and that no one would seek fruit on it. Then, Jesus continuing his journey to Jerusalem, all have forgotten the fig tree. In verse 20, Jesus and the disciples went out in the morning, passing the same path they had taken the day before. They noticed the fig tree, but its leaves were dry, and had dried to the roots. Then Peter remembering said, Master, that the fig that you damned, dried. And Jesus responding to them said, Hold faith in God. Dear brothers and friends, the fig tree had not fulfilled its function of producing figs, and was therefore a fruitless fig tree. Like all useless things that do not produce, they have to be eliminated, because if they do not bear fruit, they are not a blessing, but a curse. In the kingdom of God it is no different. Jesus said that he is the vine, and we are the sticks, and we are to bear many fruits. For that stick that beareth not fruit is cut down, and cast into the fire. Jesus said, Tend faith in God. What you have to say, say to fig tree, you will dry up, and you will never bear fruit again. And the phrase, hold faith in God. What is the relation between speaking a word and having faith in God? It means that our word has power only if it has the support of God, because we have no power. But our word, when it is established with faith in God, it produces the effect that is assigned to it. In continuation, Jesus speaks to the disciples, as follows, for in truth I say them, that whomever he says to this mountain, ergoes you and launches at the sea, and does not doubt into your heart, but querying will be held that say, all that I will say to you. At the end, he said, therefore I say them, that all that you ask for praying, believe that you will receive it, and have it. You see, faith alone does nothing. Anyone who is full of faith, but their faith is not bound to God, and is not directed to the power of God, is a useless faith, which does not produce. But when our faith is linked and directed to the power of the living God, then it is a faith that bears fruit, a useful faith, and it becomes a blessing. Then, we discover that faith is of value only when it is directed and grounded in God, and when faith uses the power of God.